Hello and welcome to another tutorial. Today we're looking at how to create a Darksaber from The Mandalorian using HitFilm Express and no add-ons. But before we get into that, if you could hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already, it really helps out the channel and lets us know what tutorials that you want to see. As I mentioned, we're going to try and avoid all add-ons if we can. We're going to do this straight out of everything that's accessible in HitFilm Express. I will be mentioning a couple of add-ons that will take your saber to the next level, but let's figure this out and just get started. First, let's talk about sorting your footage. If, like us, you're wanting to track your saber onto a subject, you'll first need to, of course, track your footage. You can do this by going into the drop-down of your footage, hitting the plus icon besides tracks, be sure to use double points to get position, scale, and rotation, and setting the tracking selection boxes over the start and end of your saber device. Then it's a case of tracking forward and back into your scene, creating a new point layer, naming it tracking point, go to the layer drop-down, and select your new point layer. Being sure to enable rotation and scale. Then you can hit apply. In our footage, we ended up filming Javert on a green screen to allow ourselves to change the background as we please. You of course may not need to do this, so we're going to skip ahead, but if you are interested in green screening and rotoscoping, you can find a playlist and the card on screen now. With the preparation done, let's make a Darksaber. So in my composite shot right now, I have my footage layer, which I've named Space Ninja, and a tracking point that has all the tracking data available. For our saber, we're going to be using one composite shot that has all the data and shape, then layering up with different things. We could of course have a series of different planes and masks, but that gets messy. This way it keeps everything kind of procedurally and we can change anything that we need to, such as shape, or even adding text in, and the effects will still apply. This is a nice way to streamline your work. So let's get started. Go to the new layer icon and select a plane. Let's get this one white and we'll call this a saber. Turn off the layer's visibility for the time being, as we don't need to see the whole thing, and go to the pen tool and just mask out the shape of your Darksaber. Luckily they're a little bit more sharp than your traditional lightsaber, so we can have it a little bit thicker and go for something like that. That's cool, we can actually turn that back on. Head on up to the selection tool, and we need to move the anchor point to the origin of the Darksaber's ignition. We can do this by going into the controls panel and moving the anchor point values. Bring this down. Now we could reposition this back in, but a simple way to do this is to copy the anchor point values and paste them over the position. And there you go. With that done, we can parent this layer to the tracking point. I'm actually going to go back into my mask and just change this ever so slightly, just to round that off a little bit more. At this point, I kind of want the saber to be igniting, so I'm going to go into the mask properties, go into transform, and hit a keyframe by path. I'll move that along a couple of frames just to give it some breathing room. And all I'm going to do is bring these two top points to the bottom of our Darksaber. So now if we review this, it should have over a couple of frames be igniting. Bam! With the base of our saber set, grab both the tracking point and this plane, and we're gonna make this into a composite shot. Let's call it Saber. I know it looks like we have a black background right now, but if we go into the options drop down and go into check of background, you can see that the alpha matte is just restricted to our saber. We need to create a black background for some of our effects to be able to work later. So go to the new layer icon, select a plane, name this BG.
You can tell by the way I use my
watch. And select black. All right, that's it. We can move back into our main composite shot. So of course, we now can't see our saber. So the first thing that we're gonna do is remove the thing that we've just added. Bear with me. By going into the keying dropdown and finding demult, we can apply that on and that will eliminate the black background. With the basic shape done, I'm going to go into the matte enhancements and grab the matte cleaner, apply that on and just feather this ever so slightly so it's not so jagged. We're gonna apply a couple of glows onto this layer in particular, as this is gonna be the back layer to everything, which is gonna be emitting the most light. So we're gonna go into the lights and flares drop down, find glow, and apply that on. Now, this is gonna be a case of trial and error. What I'm working with is gonna be different to what you're working with, but what I found is by adding a couple of glows at a small radius and building it up more and more, so just increasing in radius every single time and just keep duplicating them. This way, this glow creates a bit more of a foggy look. As this is looking a little bit clean right now, if we want to add some smoky detail into it, we can go ahead and apply a fractal noise, drop it on, and immediately that will add a weird fog. That's a little bit too much, so go into the appearance settings and set the blend mode to screen. And that'll just break it up ever so slightly. Alternatively, you can use the Lightsword Ultra Glow if you have access to the VFX Neon Pack. All you need to do is drag it on and select a preset if you like. I personally like the red distortion, and then add a tint just to make it white. With this looking pretty good, we can actually go into the blend mode and set this to add. Now we have our sword reacting with our subject. The next layer that we're going to be adding is the energy within the blade. So we're going to duplicate this saber composite shot and eliminate all the effects. Let's also rename this layer to energy and turn off the visibility for the saber layer underneath. With all the effects removed and our blend mode reset, we should have our sword and black background again. Once again, we're going to get a fractal noise, apply that on, and set the type to energy. Nice and easy. As we're after a load of texture, be sure to scale this down to something that works for you. I'm gonna go for something around like, 90, that should do the trick. We need to animate this as well. So go into the position settings, set a keyframe, then go to the end of your sequence, and I'm just gonna raise it on the Y. This will just give it that floating energy feel. In order to get our shape, this time around, we're actually gonna go into the keying set and find set matte. Make the source layer our saber and set the matte source to luminance. Let's get our old friend matte cleaner and we're going to choke this layer in and feather this a bunch as well. What we wanna do is bring it in, I probably took it in a bit too much, so I'm gonna go for around maybe 10. And let's turn our saber layer back on so we can see what we're doing. This will take a little bit of work, but you eventually get something that's good. But before we move on, I will increase the smooth just to round out some of those edges. Last layer to the saber, I swear. Grab the original saber layer and duplicate it. Let's also rename this solid and bring it to the top of our composite shot. This time around, go into the effects and remove everything but the demult. Like before, turn off the visibility to the other layers. So we have our effects removed and blend mode set, so now we need to turn this saber black. We could use a tint, but there's also another way, and that is a invert. This just takes the color data and swaps it around. Let's go ahead and turn on the visibility for the other two layers and grab a matte cleaner. Right now we've removed the fractal energy that we've created, so we're gonna need to bring this in by choking and feathering, much like before. Gonna add a little bit of smoothness in there too. If we zoom in a little bit, you can see that the edges are there, but we're not actually seeing much of the energy. Gonna bring this in even more. There you go. That's a good start, but I think one thing that we're missing from our energy is a curves. Apply that on and just bring this down. That's looking a lot better. We're getting that detail back. If we go into our fractal noise scale and decrease this even more, there we go, that's the stuff. This is looking pretty good, and I think that right now the one thing that we're missing is maybe some energy floating around in the darkness. One thing that we could do for this is apply another fractal noise. We do love a fractal. And if you go to the preset Starfield, you'll get these nice little specks just floating through. It just stops it from being complete darkness, you know? In the new Star Wars films, you see particles normally floating off the new lightsabers. We did this in Rise of the Dark Side, and it's a subtle little effect that really pays off. Now, HitFilm Express doesn't come with the Particles Simulation Pack. That is a HitFilm Pro exclusive. But if you're interested in particles and wanting to learn, there is an effect available in HitFilm Express that we can use right now to play around. To get around this, we're actually gonna be using one of the quick 3D effects. In the effects panel, head on down to quick 3D and select bonfire. Drag this into the timeline and it'll create a new layer for you. Now we have a small fire created for us. We're actually gonna be using this smoke and debris in order to create these particles. First things first, head on down to the fire dropdown and move the size to 0. We're not gonna be using the fire. We're just gonna keep the smoke and embers. I'm going to rotate and position this to align with our saber origin. So if we now go into the smoke dropdown, we can decrease the density of this down and maybe the size as well, just so it's not as prominent. That is very subtle. So we can go into the embers now. And first things first, I'm going to change the color to white. So now let's add some turbulence to really make this a little bit more scattered and less uniform. I'm gonna decrease my size just ever so slightly. I feel like I've got too many particles right now, so I'm going to bring that down to about half and also decrease the spread so it's not as sluffy. The last thing that we need to do is obviously set this to a tracking point. Now, where are we going to get one of those? Head into the Saber composite shot, grab your tracking point, copy it, and bring it back into this layer. Be sure to realign it. Once realigned and in a position that you want, set this bonfire layer to the tracking point. Like me, you may need to rotate this back around. These look good, but the last thing I think I'm gonna add to them is a glow, just to really bring them out. Last thing we do before adding the background is, of course, apply motion blur. If, like us, you've done your work on a green screen, now is the time to add in your background and start compositing. But if you're interested in making your own backgrounds, then you should check out our previous tutorial on making 3D environments in Unreal. Javert breaks down the entire process on how to get started in Unreal and to use data from Camtrack AR to create your own DIY virtual production. And that's it for today's tutorial. I do hope that you've had a good time and managed to find some of this helpful. If there is a Star Wars related effect that we've not covered before, let us know in the comment section down below and we will be sure to cover it in future. Till next time, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time.